I'll be going over how to set BPM and various techniques to make your visual sets more dynamic using BPM Sync. First thing I'll talk about is the BPM interface, and this is located at the bottom left of the layers. This is your BPM value, and if you click on it, you can input the value manually. The plus and minus buttons here add or subtract one from your BPM, and the divide by two and multiply by two buttons double or half the amount of your BPM. This moving square here is your BPM clock, and it's a visual indication of your current BPM. The tap button is used to manually find the BPM of your audio track by tapping to the beat. This is good for live improvisation or situations where you don't have any audio information. And the resync button restarts the BPM clock to the first bar or beat of your audio. Now I'm going to load up a song to show you how all of this works together. The key to finding BPM is understanding where the bars and beats are in a track. But if you're not familiar with the song, you can usually just get away with doing a 4 count. So let's do it on beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're at about 80 BPM, and I'll resync it here. Now if you look at the BPM clock and listen to the beat, it's pretty close. Since I know the BPM of this track, I'll just input it. It's actually 79, so not too far off. So I'll resync this. And if you pay attention to the BPM clock, you'll notice that it's on beat. So what can you do with BPM sync? Well, one of the things I like to do is randomize the playback of a clip. Let me load up Fragmentalized and play that back normally. In the transport area here in the clip, you can click on this pull-down menu on the right side and go to BPM Sync. Right off the bat, you'll notice Resolume makes an estimation on how long the clip is in beats. And you can manually adjust this by inputting a number or using the buttons here. And by cutting the beats in half, it's playing back similar to the original here. Let's go back to BPM Sync, and to randomize playback of this video clip, you press this R button right here. And what this does is randomly play back the video at different parts to the BPM that you set. So this is a nice way to get your visuals in sync with the music. Another cool feature of BPM Sync is the Beat Looper. And the Beat Looper is a way to repeat playback of a clip to the current BPM. So this visual is all seeing eye, and if I click on the pull down menu in the transport area of the clip and change to BPM Sync, Beat Looper shows up below the playback controls. This gives you the ability to loop parts of a video clip depending on the number of beats, and you can do this playing backwards, random, or forward. But let's go backwards. Now if I click on one beat, it'll repeat this part of the video clip every beat. According to the BPM, you can do half, which is faster. And if you notice here, it's actually playing on beat now. You could mix it up depending on the song. So just play around with it. It's a good way to synchronize and play along with the music. Next thing I'll be talking about is how to sync effects with BPM. So I'll load up a new visual here, square dancing. And I'll be using the low res effect to show you how this works. So add the low res effect to the visual. And the parameter that I want to adjust is pixel size. And what this does is create somewhat of a pixel or 8-bit effect to your visuals. To BPM sync this parameter, you click on the small arrow next to the name here and click BPM sync. Right off the bat, it'll cycle through pixel size every 4 beats. I want to change that to 1 beat and adjust the in and out points so that the higher values of pixel size get triggered every beat. So I'll resync the BPM, and you'll notice this effect is now in sync with the beat. The great thing about this technique is you can use it on any effect parameter, so the possibilities are almost endless. And that's the gist of BPM Sync and what you can do with it. If you liked any of the visuals you've seen, they're available at docoptic.com. in addition to Resolume tutorials and other information regarding live visuals and content. As always, thanks for watching.